Hi, I'm Ted Venema. Let's talk now about hearing aids and how they work. We've done lots of talks about hearing loss, causes of hearing loss, the hows, the whys, and wherefores. Now let's talk about what we can do about hearing loss. Let's look at some of the basics of hearing aids themselves. I'm going to show you a picture of an old style hearing aid. You'll still see them around a bit today. We've come a long way since then. But the top hearing aid on the left is showing you a typical hearing aid. Now, hearing aids don't look like this necessarily today anymore, but let's look at the pieces and parts of hearing aids because all of them share certain characteristics. Now, this top hearing aid here could be reminiscent of those big beige bananas that people wore behind their ears that squealed. You know, the ones that you saw in the 1990s a lot. We've come a long way again, but let's look at the pieces and parts. At the top, you're going to see a microphone. All hearing aids have a microphone. A microphone simply changes sound into electricity. The electricity in the hearing aid is then amplified, made larger, and then right beside the microphone you'll see something called the ear hook there. Well, if you look just a little bit below that, you'll see a little banded area here, and that's the speaker in a hearing aid. And a speaker is just a backward mic. A speaker changes electricity back into sound again. So the hearing aid basically has three main parts: a microphone, an amplifier, and a speaker. And the sound comes through the tube and then, of course, into the person's ear. Now, all hearing aids inside are quite complicated. There's lots of electronics taking place, and I'm not going to drag you through all of that, but let's take the tubing off the hearing aid that fits in the ear and just look at the components again of these hearing aids. This is called a behind-the-ear hearing aid. They sometimes call them BTEs, behind the ear. This is the piece that sat behind the ear. That would be the beige banana of yesterday. This would be the hook that hangs over the top of the ear, and then the tubing would come down and an ear mold would sit inside of the person's ear canal. Here's another shot looking at a basic hearing aid. Sound comes into the microphone, it's changed into electricity, it's amplified, and the amplified electricity is then changed back into sound right about here, a speaker there, and then that sound travels through the tube and into this ear mold, a piece that fits inside the client's ear. Some styles of hearing aids were called all in the ear, ITE. So here's an example of an old-fashioned ITE. By the way, they don't all look like this today either, but you gotta sometimes learn the history to appreciate where we are today, and that's kind of what we're doing here. And so you can see a little battery case here. At the top, you'll see a microphone. You can see a volume control. And once again, you'll see a little speaker opening there. You'll see another little hole there too. That's called a vent. Hearing aids like to have a hole in them to let the ear canal breathe. That's called a vent, and they're kind of useful too. You know why? If you plug up your ear, and try this once for yourself, just for the heck of it. Plug up your ear and talk. Plug one ear. When you talk with one ear plugged, you're going to hear your voice louder in that ear. That's called the occlusion effect, and that's what would happen with hearing aids. And people don't want that. They don't want to hear their voices all come louder when they talk. So the vent is a little hole that allows excess loudness of your voice to escape. So the hearing aid feels more comfortable in the ear. The air in the ear canal can communicate with the air outside, and it's more, and the sound is better as well. So in the ear hearing aid, this is a smaller in the ear hearing aid. Once again, you'll see its microphone, its battery door, its volume wheel, and if you turned it around, you'll see the little speaker. So hearing aids all have to produce sound. And notice on this top picture, all the lines going up. That means most of the amplification in the hearing aid is aimed at amplifying treble. Low pitches are on the left, highs are on the right. And you can see just by that top picture that most hearing aids are amplifying the treble more than they are amplifying the lows. And that's because most people have trouble hearing treble. Most elderly hearing loss goes down on a hearing test, as we saw in previous videos. So hearing aids want to rectify that. They want to turn that frown upside down. So, and here's another picture showing you the maximum sound that a hearing aid can ever come out, because as we know, you don't want to cause hearing loss by wearing a hearing aid. So all hearing aids limit the maximum sound that can come out as well, because you want to help the person hear, but you don't want to cause more hearing loss due to excess noise. And so these are things that the clinician needs to consider, and that all clinicians consider, because they're well trained in that. Now, just for fun, let's look at those low-cost $25, $50 hearing aids that some people buy, okay? They buy them from the back of advertisements, and well, they not only are cheap, but you get what you pay for. First of all, they look really stupid, okay? And whether you're buying the behind-the-ear style or whether you'd be buying the all-in-the-ear hearing style, you know what the problem with these hearing aids? Do you know what the problem is? They don't provide much treble. They provide an awful lot of bass. And most people don't have much difficulty hearing the bass. They've got difficulty hearing treble. And so what these hearing aids are going to sound like is, they're going to be amplifying all the voice sounds, but not those high-pitched consonants that we talked about in past videos. So beware of those low-cost, L-cheapo hearing aids. Hearing aids have a difficult task, and this is kind of a weird picture, but let me show you here, okay? Bear with me here. This is an audiogram, a hearing test that we talked about in past videos. Now here's soft sounds, the top green line there. They're only 5 decibels. And here's the person's hearing loss for his left ear, showing he can't hear until 50 decibels. He's got a 50 decibel hearing loss. Now, if sounds are only 5 decibels and they're coming into the hearing aid is going to want to amplify that so that the person can hear it. So now 5 is turned into 55. Good. Well, what if the incoming sound to the microphone is 60? Well, the person can hear that, but how much does the hearing aid want to amplify sounds coming in that are 60? Not by as much, because remember, what happens with hearing loss? You can't hear the soft sounds, but the loudness tolerance hasn't changed. In other words, the floor has been elevated, but the ceiling of loudness tolerance hasn't been elevated. So hearing aids have to amplify soft sounds by a lot and loud sounds by little or nothing at all. Here's a way of looking at that. Here's soft decibels, 10, going up to 100. Okay? And here's a person's perception of that. So follow the red line. That would be normal hearing. Okay? To a normal hearing person, 10 decibels sounds soft. To a normal hearing person, 50 decibels sounds comfortable. To a normal hearing person, 100 sounds too loud. But now pretend that you've got that 50 decibel hearing loss over here. Okay, look at those blue X's. Now pretend you've got that. So now you can't hear till about 50 or 60. Well, 50 or 60 now sounds very soft, and yet 100 sounds too loud. Okay, your floor has risen, but your ceiling of loudness tolerance hasn't. So hearing aids need to amplify soft sounds by a lot and loud sounds by little or nothing at all. And think of having an amplifier that would do that. An amplifier that would change the amount by which it's amplifying constantly, all depending on the loudness of the sound coming into the mic. If the sound coming in is soft, the hearing aid is working hard. If the sound gets louder coming into the mic, the hearing aid automatically backs off. That's high-end technology. That's how technology in hearing aids seeks to imitate what the hair cells do inside the cochlea. Hearing loss, fitting hearing loss with hearing aids. There's a lot to it. Thanks for listening.